Hello, YouTube. I'm Zach. You're watching ZachDTV, the place for interesting news from around the net. In today's episode, we're going to talk about a convention for toy lovers. We also have a personal drone that can swim underwater. And we're going to wrap it up with a guy who can sleep anywhere. All right, let's get right into this. Let's start off with an event for all you people who are fans of Transformers, My Little Pony, G.I. Joe, things like Monopoly, whatever. Hasbro is having a convention. They're calling it the HasCon Family Event. And it's going to take place September 8th through 10th at the Rhode Island Convention Center. Now, of course, like any convention, it's going to have guest speakers. It's going to have voice talent, like the guy who does Optimus Prime. Some people from My Little Pony are going to be there. Stuff like that. They're going to have different events, different setups. According to Hasbro, this is going to bring their products like Nerf and everything else to life like never before. They're going to have their exclusive product reveals at this show. And they're even teaming up with Disney on this. So that's going to bring in, say, stuff like, you know, Disney princesses. We're going to have Star Wars at it. And even Marvel will be there as well. According to Hasbro president John Frascati, Hasbro constantly strives for new ways to bring our storytelling to life and offer fans greater access to our brands. And HasCon is designed to bring attendees closer to Hasbro's biggest properties than ever before. Tickets for the event are on sale right now. It's $30 for children, $60 for adults, and $600 if you want the VIP pass. And you know, people are going to buy it. For my next story, let's talk about a drone that's going to be coming out later this year. It's made by a Beijing-based company called RoboSea, and it's the Beaky or Bicky. I'm not sure which way you pronounce it. And this thing is called a RoboFish. It is an underwater drone that swims like a fish. It is propelled forward by its tail movements. Now, this RoboFish does come with a 4K camera. It can swim independently on a pre-programmed path. You can let it just swim around autonomously. It even has sensors to avoid collisions. Or you can control it from an app or the controller that comes with it. It can swim around and record, they say, from 90 minutes to an hour and 20 minutes. Which is a pretty good amount of time for any drone. And with its built-in GPS, if it starts running low on battery or gets out of range, it will come back to you. So that's pretty neat as well. The team behind this do say that because it moves naturally in an environment, it doesn't disturb fish or anything else like that. And some of their test footage here in the video, they do show it swimming in with other schools of fish and whatnot. So it'd be pretty neat if you could really get those undisturbed underwater photos with this new drone. And like I said, the device is due to come out later this year. It had a successful Kickstarter already. Its goal was to raise $20,000. As of filming, it was at $62,000. So it's good and covered. If you get in and fund it early, they're offering it for $549. But to buy it when it comes out is going to cost you $1,024. And I forgot to mention on this, it does have a dive depth of 194 feet. So that is pretty deep. This is something you could take in the rivers, the creeks, the swimming pool, or even the ocean to get some pretty cool footage. For my final story, I want to tell you about Carl Webb. Last Thursday, Carl was on his way home from a barbecue event down by Memphis, Tennessee. On his way home, he was on the highway. He got stopped by a police officer. Now, of course, he thought, well, was I speeding? Was I doing something wrong? Who knows? The cop walks up to his car and says, "I'm not messing with you. There's a body on your trunk." While we don't have a name for this guy, what seems to have happened here is the guy was extremely drunk. So drunk, in fact, that he almost stumbled out into traffic when he was woken up off the trunk. That he had fallen asleep at the barbecue fest, which was 14 miles away from where Carl was pulled over. And slept on the trunk at highway speeds without waking up. I swear, people, I can't make this stuff up. That is ridiculous. Now, there's no word on charges or anything like that for this guy. I'm thinking maybe they get him for public drunkenness, but he was just trying to sleep it off. So, was he really doing anything wrong? I don't know. Well, with that, I'm going to wrap it up. Hey, if you like what I do, go ahead and click that subscribe button over here. I do this Monday through Friday. That's 5 days a week. If you want more news like this, if you want to know every time I upload a new video, go ahead and hit that bell notification as well. And that'll alert you to my new uploads. Today is Wednesday, so I'll be back tomorrow. You guys, be safe.